Your mind. Corridors of Power on NDTV Hindu, Sunday night at 9:30.
Welcome back to Enterprising Entrepreneurs with Srinath Rajaram, CEO of NP Compete. Srinath, you mentioned a 10 lakh sort of current take home per annum. Now, if you look at recent IIT Madras placements, apparently they got starting salaries of 67 lakh per annum. You're no less than an IIT, and in fact, you've got much more. Apart from your IISc background, you also went on to the Indian School of Business. So many years into your career, and if it's going to be 10 lakh, you know, which is, you know, way beyond what a fresh IIT grad gets, what does it take to actually stay on in this entrepreneurship initiative of yours?
I think that has two things. You need money for either, I remember the first conversation I had when I was trying to interview for a startup. There are two components to your salary. One is your income, the other is your wealth. Now, you choose to take your income the way that you want, and you choose to build the wealth the way that you want. So, the preferred way is to put both of them together and call it salary. The other way to do that is say that I'm going to meet my needs through my salary, but I'll play my bets on the wealth.
So, you want your NP Compete to be a sort of a nest egg for you?
No, I want it to be a nest egg for everybody. So, I want it to be the kind of company that people would come to work for, and they would actually... Let's say it would be a role, Infosys would be a role model. I want people to become rich off this. So maybe I may not end up becoming rich, but I want everybody to get rich.
Okay. But what financial sense does it make for you personally and for your family?
I think that it makes a lot of sense. Like I said, eventually it's how much financial sense does it make if you look back at it, for someone to have invested in a home in US in 2007. Right? I had a lot of salary. Let's say that I've been working for Cisco. I made a lot of money. I went and invested all my on a fantastic house, and because I thought that value will improve. Right now, these guys are underwater. So it's a risk. It's always a risk. Wealth accumulation is always a risk. It's your appetite for risk that differs. And we have a larger appetite for risk. By risk, I mean the variation in the eventual outcome. I think that we have a larger appetite for that. So we are fine with that.
Talking of your application, if you can just show us, for the benefit of our viewers, to sort of simplify this, otherwise they shouldn't get befuddled with technical jargon.
Yeah, so this is an interesting app that we did for rugby league in Wales. If you really think about this, this could be a Chennai Super Kings app. Okay, so you can have like the fixtures, results. So these are the fixtures, these are the matches that are going on. You can look at what is going on live, if there's something live that shows up, and then results, what are the matches that have happened and what are the results for those matches. So what really happened, what was the lineup for this match. So go inside, you can actually find out what each of these players did in each one of these things. So this is what he did in each one of these.
So you could have this for an IPL, for instance. Technically,
yes,
you can. That will be big business for you.
It'll be an
amazing. You've not approached the IPL.
Not yet. But that's also partly because I think that these plans are already on the anvil for a lot of the teams. But this will be a fantastic...
Why not maybe something like the Chennai Open, the tennis tournament?
Absolutely. That would be a fantastic market, and that's something that...
You've thought of them as a potential customer.
We have thought of the IPL as a potential customer, but thanks for the idea.
Maybe because that's based out of Chennai entirely.
Yes, and maybe that's someone that we need to talk to immediately. And IPL is, maybe if it works for IPL, hey, nothing like it. Yes, we will talk to them.
Okay, and what about some of the other apps?
This is Sham, a customer of ours.
Hi.
And, hi, nice to meet you.
Same, yeah. So, you're his customer?
Yes, I am.
What made you actually place trust in this young man?
Oh.
Because he's done very unconventional things in his life.
Absolutely. So I was his classmate back in IISc too.
So your customer, so your network is strong.
It always...
Even if you don't get your ex employers, as your clients, you have your former classmates. Some of your co-founders are also what, your classmates of?
They were my colleagues. They were my colleagues and...
Where? In Wipro?
In Wipro, okay. Yeah. Actually, all three of us came from Wipro. So Wipro has an excellent track record of supporting entrepreneurs.
Okay.
So I think KB Chandrasekhar of Jamcracker was one of the earliest persons to come out. And then you have Ashok Soota doing, Mindtree and now Happiest Mind. So
tell us about this app.
So this app is called LexTalk, and so we are a early stage startup company based out of Sunnyvale, California.
Mm-hmm.
So we came to Srinath to develop this application, which is basically a communication and collaboration application for enterprise and professional users.
Mm.
So what we see is a huge gap in the market with respect to a tool which actually understands business and brings in the new social collaboration tools like Facebook or a Twitter feed to it.
Mm-hmm.
So things are starting to change in the enterprise. You must have heard of Atos, for instance. Mm. They have actually declared that they're going to ban email from the organization in favor of something like Twitter and instant messaging platforms.
Mm.
So what we feel is...
There are a lot of organizations which ban even Facebook and Twitter in their offices.
No, but we are talking about an organization banning email even for official usage.
Yes.
Okay.
They have about 75,000 employees and they have banned email in their organization. The logic being email is a medium. It was a tool which was developed to replace inter-office memos, if you will. So it has far outlived its usage right now.
Mm.
And what we're looking at is the age of Twitter, where whole countries start revolutions based on messages which are flowing at light speed.
So how will this, in a nutshell, help someone's business?
Sure, absolutely. So right now, a business is viewed as a set of teams or a project teams which work towards a particular goal. And these teams could exist either within the organization, or typically you basically interact with vendors and partners who are across organizational boundaries. So what we do is we offer a service which will allow you to model these teams and have conversations, just as what I'm having with you.
Mm.
I don't need to worry about whether I'm having a text chat or am I doing a voice call or is it a conference or do I have to take some other tool to model my sales conversation or a customer relationship conversation. Everything is combined into a set of very easy constructs which we can model and basically keep the knowledge together within the team.
What revenue sense does it make for you to design these apps? Do you think corporates at a time when there's cost cutting also on the anvil would see this as a frill, or would they see this as
actually, if you think about it, it's the other way around. So what Shyam
this
is
will help you in cost cutting.
What Shyam is telling is something very interesting, which is what it's going to help them in cost cutting, because look at what's happening right now. I talk on the phone with you and then I write an email and then 6 months later I want to remember something. I have shreds of email and maybe some memories, and it's he said and she said, right? You remember something, I remember something else.
So how will this help?
This is going to make sure that you don't ever have to lose knowledge that you already have. See, in a knowledge economy, as Narayan Murthy said, your assets walk out of the elevator every day, right? If you want to really protect those assets, eventually you have to be able to make sure that these assets are in some way, the knowledge of these assets translate into, a real benefit for the organization. So that's what it is. And it may not benefit immediately in a cost-cutting world, but what would happen is that it would yield to, in a long term, it's going to be an interesting play because it's going to be really easy for people to generate more and more revenues from the existing knowledge. Think of it just like an asset. You put 10 rupees in the bank, it keeps giving you 10 paisa every month.
Talking about those who put things in the bank, your co-founders who put in all the money, what actually made you put in money? Because he didn't put in money himself, he didn't put in any seed capital. So were you guys the guinea pigs in a sense?
We didn't look at it that way. We didn't even, till this point, we never even thought about answering this question.
It's an inconvenient question, but it's a logical question. And
we probably had more money than you.
Okay. You don't see yourself as a guinea pig, or probably you...
Actually, we have been, all three of us were talking about doing this for a while, right? And logically, when we decided to move ahead with this, he was the first person to get out and start off. And we kind of faced each of us joining it.
So he was a guinea pig, actually?
Kind of, yes. Exactly.
And you believed in this, what an idea, Sergi, kind of concept that he had?
Yes. So, you know, so we thought since he is getting in first and taking the risk there, right? Logically, like, you know, we'll start, you know, investing our money in, and slowly we'll also face in and we'll join in. So that's how we kind of decided. So
all of you, I mean, they're three, they're like partners or co-founders, or how does it work? There's a revenue sharing.
Actually, there are even employees who are co-founders. So we believe in completely sharing.
So you like
they
get sort of get what would be the equivalent of ESOPs?
They get actually stakes, yes, ESOPs, yes.
Okay.
So when you come back to, I think one of the myths, I'll just segue into the first part when we're talking about the, you know, one of the myths or one of the important parts of starting a business. I think that you were talking about the boss and all those things. If at all, there was one thing that I think I did right, it was in picking this team.
Mm.
Sometimes I wonder why these guys picked me, but I am sure that I
lucked
out.
Why he picked me, actually.
Mm. This is mutual admiration society, but great. I mean, we started
that
off.
That needs to be there.
When we started off, somewhere in the middle of the interview, I referred to you rather jocularly as the three idiots, and you said what the three musketeers. But since we are in this Christmas season, maybe it's appropriate to refer to all of you as the three wise men, and hopefully we will get to see many a Santa Claus in the months and the years ahead, and all the very best to you. And again, hats off to all of you to have actually decided to live your dream in a sense. Thank you very much. Pleasure talking to you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Nice meeting you.
Same here.